Your life is on contract. Your best bet is to stay away, motherfucker. It's just one of those days. It's all about the he says, she says bullshit. I think you better quit, let shit slip.
Hey guys, this is Carlitos coming to you live from Oceanside, California at Tournament Park at Camp Pendleton. Marine Base. We're out here with AFPL. We're running this new 7-man X-Ball beta format run by John Arquilla. We got our next two teams that are coming up. It's Techno Kitty versus Muffin Stuffers. Now, Muffin Stuffers has got a hell of a reputation for, you know, putting the smackdown on some people, but it seems like Techno Kitty decided to bring the rain with B-Short from Dynasty and Cody Dufon from, looks like, the SD Pirates. So this is gonna be a pretty interesting match. Seven guys on the gate, and they gotta hit a central buzzer, which is gonna be the way you can score a point. Got 10 seconds left on the clock. Everybody's lining up, gearing up. Here it comes. And they're off. Looks like a pretty aggressive breakout. Both teams taking a couple losses, but paint's flying all over the place. Oh. Looks like B-Short's having a little bit of gun problems. I guess that's how you take the pro guy out of the equation, but hopefully the rest of the team can put things together. Muffin Stuffers are still sitting pretty strong. Oh, not a lot of talking going on, just a lot of paint, a lot of shooting paint. Muffin Stuffer's got a guy at the 50A, our AFPL 50A bunker, and he's just kind of sitting waiting for the opportunity to make the move. Looks like he might get up and try to snag that bunker, that buzzer. Oh, somebody just moved into Dorito 3 on Techno Kitty side. See if that changes up the game a little bit. It's getting quiet. They're hunting for wabbits. Oh, 50A player on Muffin Stuffers gets shot out underneath the A, so seems like everybody's just kind of sitting back and waiting. Everybody's got their eye on that buzzer, trying to score a point. And that's the buzzer.
2 minutes.
So Alex Campbell from Techno Kitty goes ahead and takes that point.
5:01 remaining.
It's a pretty good move by him. Something heads up. Got a couple other teams. Heaven and Hell coming from Baja California. Drove all the way up here last night and stayed up here in Oceanside. I had a practice yesterday getting ready for this 7-man beta. So an explanation on 7-man beta is you got 7 guys, there's 7 minutes that's on the clock, and it's a continuously running clock. So it's like an X-Ball format, so it's never gonna stop, and you got 2 minutes in between each point. So you're playing 7 minutes, as many points as you possibly can. The balls per second is 13. So you got that X-Ball feel, a little bit of the 7-man. So it makes it pretty interesting as far as like the breakouts, because you're playing on a PSP field. I mean, they extended the snake a little bit, about an extra bunker or so. So it seems like everybody's out here having fun, enjoying the sun and everything. It was a little chilly this morning, but we got the games rolling. So a couple of things that wanted to kind of talk about is the new upcoming season for 2015. The AFPL is going to be going pretty big. They're going to have the AFPL here in Oceanside, California, and then it seems like we're going to be doing the AFPL Internacional, which they're going international down into Mexico. So their first event of the season is going to be in February 28th and March 1st. It's going to be a Red Zone event at Gotcha Paintball in Cancun, Mexico. Now, I just came back from Cancun. I played the Mexican Paintball League, and I can tell you it is beautiful. The surf, the beaches, the ladies, the drinks, it's amazing. Just a great venue, great place to be. I think a lot of teams are going to have a lot of fun when they go down there. I know the New Jersey Jesters are bringing a team down for Red Zone. I know the OC Titans are probably going to come on down. Cobra Kai, which is another team that's out here from San Diego, California, is going to be going down. I know that the Warriors, which is a team that's coming out of Tabasco, Mexico, they're going to be playing. Another team called Blackwater from Mexicali might be coming out. So it's going to be an awesome event. It's going to be a lot of fun. And just playing Red Zone. So we got Muffin Stuffers on the left, and we got Techno Kitty on the right.
10 seconds.
10 seconds left on the clock. Everybody's lining up, checking their guns, making sure they work this time. Man, looks like a crowd up there. But Muffin Stuffers takes an aggressive breakout and pushes Snake off the break. 50A. And now they're just gonna sit back and wait and try to see if they can get a couple guys out and try to hit that buzzer. They're down a point, so let's see what happens. Cody Dufon doing the run around the Dorito corner. Looks like he was dancing around it. Everybody kind of checking their bunkers, you know, shooting their lanes. Not much going on. I figured there'd be a little bit more aggressive. Oh, there we go. Techno Kitty makes a move into their Dorito 3. It's a good spot for them to kind of watch that buzzer. Oh, and Muffin Stuffers, number 9. I don't know who he is, but took one in the face. Very nice. Oh, and it looks like their 58 guy takes another one to the face. So Muffin Stuffers loses their two most forward guys. They're closest to the buzzer. And Techno Kitty's strategy to just sit back and shoot out some stuffers is kind of working out. Not much movement on the right side. Just kind of sitting there waiting. Looks like Techno Kitty finally moves it into the snake. Oh, Muffin Stuffers loses two more. So now they've only got two left.
3 minutes remaining.
With 3 minutes left remaining in the match. I don't know, it looks like this has been completely one-sided. Looks like B-Short's looking at that buzzer. He's looking for it. He's looking for the move. Might be able to make it. If he makes it up, yeah, he's creeping. And, is he gonna hit it? And B-Short hits the buzzer multiple times. And now,
2 minutes.
And now it works. 2 minutes left in the clock. Techno Kitty takes that point, so now they're up 2-0.
All right, Techno Kitty takes that point, 2-0.
I'm gonna take. So we got Heaven and Hell and the OC Titans that come from SenCal, and they're up next. It's gonna be pretty interesting. Now kind of gearing towards back what we were talking about for the new 2015 season. There's a lot of teams that are coming up in the works. You know, Muffin Stuffers kind of is a throw together ragtag team from Straight Shooters and a couple other guys from up in Los Angeles and Whittier. You know, they're looking pretty solid. You know, we'll see what kind of impact they end up having for next season if they play the AFPL. They're definitely playing Red Zone, as confirmed. Another team is Cobra Kai out of San Diego, California. Those guys have been looking solid all year. Mostly they've been kind of guesting with a myriad of different teams. They've been playing with LA Hitman. You know, they've been playing with, I can't even keep track. LA Hitman, the Warriors, they played down in Mexico with Drink and Destroy and a couple other teams there. So, you know, those are two teams to look for coming up in next season. Techno Kitty looks like they're doing their thing. And, you know, they're going to be a force to reckon with for AFPL next season. Got 5 seconds left. Oh, they're running. They tagged up Muffin Stuffers, and they were able to get all 7 guys on the gate in time. Muffin Stuffers pushes somebody up to the 50. And he gets kind of blasted out of there real quick. Muffin Stuffers got to make it happen right now. They got 2 minutes remaining left in the match. And kind of seems like they're just sitting waiting back. Not really making too many big moves. Techno Kitty loses their god player. And Alex Campbell, the infamous Russian, sitting there in that tower, just holding down the button lane, or the buzzer lane, so Muffin Stuffers can't get that point. So, and Muffin Stuffers gets shot in the face trying to run for the buzzer. It seems like they've been getting shot in the face a lot. I don't know, maybe they should check their lanes. Check their lanes before they get lit up. And it looks like Techno Kitty takes the point again and ringing the buzzer.
Man.
Something's gotta happen for the Muffin Stuffers. They're down to Techno Kitty 3-0. Seems like everybody's having a lot of fun with this 7-man. You know, paint. I think that it just kind of gives a lot of people a different look and different format. I mean, John and the AFPL have always been really good with giving something to the spectators and giving something to the players to just like have fun from, you know, the norm PSP or WC events or RPL events. So, you know, we want to be able to give something to the spectators, and you know, that's why he created Red Zone. And you know, a lot of people in the off season were asking for a 7-man event, and you know, John kind of threw everything into the kettle and concocted this 7-man X-Ball format, and seems like it's coming along promisingly. He had 7 teams that signed up. He had the OC Titans, Heaven and Hell, the Techno Kitties, they had Muffin Stuffers, Cobra Kai, and Narkill, another team that comes out of the woodwork, who haven't been too prevalent because they've been reffing the WC events, WCPPL. So, but now they came down. They heard about 7-man and they were stoked, and they were one of the first teams to kind of get together, sign up, and come out and have a good day of paintball here at the tournament park in Oceanside, California. So, we've got about 25 seconds left before we kick this next one off. 10 seconds left on the clock. Everybody lines up. Seems like Muffin Stuffers are kind of ride or die right now, just pushing all 7 guys up the field. All 7 guys up the field, and it looks like they might get it. Did they get it? Oh, it looked like a good strategy, but looks like all 7 guys ended up getting pretty shot up. And Techno Kitty takes that looks like that final point. So Techno Kitty takes that one, so now it's 4-0 Techno Kitty. Looks like the ultimate refs decided to call the game, so Techno Kitty took it 4-0. Congrats to Techno Kitty.